Hi, today we will see the continuation of the last video. In last video I have finished with the types of the array. Actually there is only two types. One is one dimension array and another one is multi-dimension array. If the dimension of the array is more than one, then it is a multi-dimension array. But for to make you understand more, I have given one dimension, two dimension, then I have gone for the multi-dimension. We will see the syntax of the two-dimension array first, because in last video I have shown more examples for one-dimension array. Whatever I have written over there as example, everything is a one-dimension array. So here I have written the two-dimension array. The data syntax is the same. The syntax of the two-dimension array is same. Data type, variable name, and here we are going to see two dimension. One is the row size and another one is the column size. Here the two dimension where it is going to be used, if you see a table, creation of any table of data, there you will be having one row and another rows and columns. So in those cases, two dimension array will be helpful. So there is a two dimension which is a row size and another one is the column size. If you want to create on table with the row size of 3 and 4, with the row size of 3 and the column size of 4, then you can create one variable with the data type and the name. Here you can write 3 and 4. So 3 is the maximum size of the row and 4 is the maximum size of the column. So example, we will see I have created one data type called integer, and A is the name of the array, and 3 is the row size and 4 is the column size. To make you more understand, I have given row 3 rows, so it, you know that array will start with 0, so row 0, row 1 and row 2, and for column it will be from 0 to 3. So if you want to create one table, then you can use the array name, only one array name with multiplication of the row size and column size. Here I have created 3 rows and 4 columns, so total number of values can be stored in an array value A is number 12. So you can store 12 values in a single array A. So initialization is almost the same. You have seen in the last video of the single array initialization, same like here also. For this you can initialize like this. If you will initialize like this, then it will take first 3 values will be in the first row, then next 3 value will be in the second row. Otherwise you can create like this also, then you can create like this also. If you leave the first, this it will take as a first row, then it will take it as a second row, because our creation is 2 row and a 3 column. So 2 row in the sense it will take 1 in the first row and 2 in the second row, but our number of elements is, total number of element is 6, whereas in the first row 3 columns should be there, but we have created only 2 row. The rest of the third column will be 0, and in the second row only you have initialized with the number 2, rest of the values will be filled with 0. In mathematics, to create the matrix you can go for two dimension array. Multi dimension array is a little bit interesting, which is more than number 2 dimension. So syntax I have given, same syntax, data type and the array name. Then dimension is up to your wish, how many dimension you want. So for that, in general I have given the syntax. So dimension 1, dimension 2, dimension 3, dimension 4, like that till dimension n, how many dimension you want. D is the dimension, dn is the size of the final dimension. If you want to create 5 dimension, then you can go up to that. So examples also I have given, data type and variable name. Then here it is 3 dimension, so 5 into 5 into 20, total number of elements. Then another example, it is 5 dimension, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So dimension is 5, but the length of the each dimension is different. You can give whatever length you want to give. So first example, if you see, you know it, integer represents the array type and table is the name of the 3D array. You know it, 5 into 5 into 20, so total number of this total number of the values which can be stored in the array table is 500 because 5 into 5 into 20. So the capacity of the array table is 500 elements you can store it. For second example, float is the data type, array is the name of the array. So total number to be stored in array is 5 into 6 into 5 into 6 into 5. So total is 4500 element. In array, you can single array, you can create it with one name where you can hold the more than 1000 number of values in the array. So here for your understanding, I am going to take only the 3D array to make you more understand in the multidimensional array. So it's in collection of 2D array. As we are seeing the 3D array, it is a collection of 2D array. If you take a 2D array, it is a collection of single dimension array. If you are going for 4D array, then it is a collection of 3D array. So to make you see one example I have given, 3D array. It is 3 into 3 into 3. So 3 into 3 into 3, 27 elements are there. This is the 0th 2D array. This is the second 2D array. This is the first 2D array. This is the second 2D array. To make you clear, I can tell you one example. 3 cross 3 cross 3. You can consider one cube. So which have length, breadth and height all are same, but you can cut to one box, you can take one cube, you can cut into 3 pieces of 3 sides. So you will get 27 small boxes in the cube. So 3D array is like that. So length, breadth and height. So 3D you should imagine, and you should cut it into 3 pieces on all the 3 sides. So you will be getting 27 small boxes. This is how the memory location will be created for the 3D array. This is for understanding, but actually it will be stored in a memory location in a different way. I will show you one example, one program, so that you will understand. So just it is a header file, then it's a main program, then I have created one integer variable ijk. I will tell you why I have created this ijk. This ijk is for printing purpose of this 3 into 3 into 3 3D 3 dimension array for a loop. Then I have created one array with 3 into 3 into 3 so that it can hold up to 27 elements. So here it is the first 2D array with a 9 elements. This is the second, this is the third, but as per the computer it is 0th 2D array. This is the first 2D array, this is the second 2D array. Then I have given the printf, which I want to print 3D array elements as a topic. Then to print it, I have taken 3 for loops, because I cannot give every time 27 times, I cannot give this value 000, 001, 010, like this I cannot give. For that I have taken for loop, inside it just I have given ijk and I have given the condition, our array is up to 3 maximum. So first I will be 0, then j will be, this is true, then again the j equals 0 is true, again k equals 0 is true, then first value will be ARR of 000 will be printed. Then again this loop, k will be incremented, then 001, again k will be incremented, 002, when it is becoming 3, then condition is false, then it will go to the next loop, then j will be first 0, for that it is executed, for this time j will be 1, when j will be 1, again this loop will be executed, that time k will be 0. So 0 1 0 it will be printed, then again 0 1 1 because kth loop again this will run second time, again third time, then again it will go for j. So when it is 1 it is over, again j will be 2, again this will be running kth loop, inner loop. So again once j is getting over, then it will come for the I, then again I will be incremented to 2, again this condition not true, again it will be running, again when I is equal to 2, then again it will be running, like this all the values will be printed. I will show you how to run this program in the open source OS. I am using Ubuntu OS. Here I have just running the C program compiler, then this is hyphen object, I have created one object for this file, this file name I have stored as 3D array dot C. I am just compiling it to run it to see the output dot slash this object name a dot out. If you give, you will get the output. So this is the first, so 0th 2 dimensional array, this entire elements, this is the first 2 dimensional array, this is the second 2 dimensional array. So total array I have printed. So this is how it will be stored in the memory. These are all the 1000, 2004, these are all the memory addresses. And this will be taking 2 bytes to store the integer value in the memory. This will vary according to the data type. If you want to access any of the value from this 3 dimensional array, then you should see in which array it is to be stored. If you want to access number 25, this is the 0th array, this is the first array, this is the second array. And 0, so first column will be, this is 0, so this is 1. So for 25th is in the this 0, this is sorry, 25 number is in the first 2 dimensional array. So this will be 1. Then if you see in the 2 dimension array, everyone is here, there is a 3 blocks, this block is 2 dimension, this block is 2 dimension, this block is 2 dimension, because row is there, column is there. So you want 25. If you see here, this is 0th row, this is first row, this is second row, so 25 is in first row. Again if you see column, 0th column, first column, second column, so 25th is in first column. So if you want to access number 25, then first ARR is your variable name, and 111 will be the location of this. So if you want to access 25, then you can give ARR 111, then you will be getting the access of number 25. So hope you have understood what is types of, what are all the types of array, what is multi-dimensional array, everything. If you want to just imagine about the 4 dimensional array, just imagine like it is a collection of 3 dimensional array. Okay, thank you, I will meet you in next video.